It was summertime on the island of Sodor. All the engines were very busy. They carried freight and passengers up and down the lines. Sir Topham Hatt came to see Emily.
I am opening some new routes for the summer, he announced. Emily, you will pull the flour mill special.
Thank you, sir, said Emily. She was pleased. Emily stopped to fill up with water on the way to the flour mill, but James was already there. Sir Topham Hatt has given me the flour mill special, said Emily.
You're lucky, James huffed. I have to do the Blacklock run.
Why don't you like going to Blacklock? Asked Emily.
There are boulders all over the tracks, he moaned. They bash your buffers and scratch your paint. And there's the Blacklock monster.
What's the Blacklock monster?
Nobody knows, said James. Black figures move in the water and then they disappear.
Oh. And James puffed away. Emily was pleased she didn't have to go to Blacklock.
At the flour mill, the flour had been loaded onto trucks. Emily was coupled up. Then she puffed across the countryside to Knapford Station. But the troublesome trucks saw a chance for mischief.
Hold back! Hold back! They screeched.
Emily pulled as hard as she could. But the troublesome trucks made her go very slowly. Emily was late delivering the flour. So there would be no fresh bread that day. Sir Topham Hatt was cross.
This means I won't have any toast or muffins for breakfast. If you are late again, you will have to do the Blacklock run instead of James.
Emily didn't want to have her buffers bashed by boulders, and she didn't want to see the Blacklock monster.
I must get the flour to the station on time, Emily puffed.
The next morning, the troublesome trucks tricked her again.
Off we go! Off we go!
They chuckled, but they weren't coupled up properly.
Mustn't be late! Mustn't be late! They giggled.
So Emily puffed quickly away. But only half the troublesome trucks went with her. Emily arrived at the station.
But you've only brought half the flour,
the station master cried. So Emily had to go back for the rest of the troublesome trucks.
Oh no, Emily cried. I don't want to get the Blacklock run.
When Emily arrived at the mill, the trucks were more troublesome than ever.
Emily, the late engine, Emily, the late engine, they sang.
This made Emily very cross. And she biffed them very hard.
Oh no,
they cried, and they splashed into the duck pond. Emily was covered in a floury mess. That evening, Sir Topham Hatt came to see Emily.
Emily, you have caused confusion and delay, Sir Topham Hatt said. Now you are to take over the Blacklock run.
Emily was very unhappy.
Wait until you've tried it, Thomas puffed. The Blacklock run might be nice.
I don't think so, Emily moaned. Bash buffers and a big monster? It sounds miserable to me.
The next morning, Emily puffed sadly to the station. Lots of excited children and vacationers climbed on board.
They're all looking forward to their vacation, she thought. I mustn't let them down.
Shh. Soon, Emily was steaming up hills and through valleys. I bet it won't last, she said to herself. Emily reached the murky waters of Blacklock.
Oh.
That's where the monster's supposed to be, she puffed nervously. Then there was trouble. Rocks fell and blocked the line.
Oh no!
Emily had to wait for help.
I knew I wouldn't like this route, she huffed.
Suddenly, she saw something dark and mysterious moving in the water.
And now the monster's coming, Emily gasped.
Emily was scared. Her boiler quivered and her valves rattled. She wanted to steam away.
I never want to see Blacklock again, she cried.
But Emily thought of the children in the coach behind her. She was determined to get them to their vacation, whatever it took. At last, the water settled, and Emily saw what the monster really was.
It's a family of seals. Emily was delighted.
The children were delighted, too. Soon, the line was cleared. Emily steamed on through the countryside. The children would reach their vacation on time. That evening, Thomas and Emily both stopped to watch the seals. You were right, said Emily. Blacklock is a nice route after all.